Thanks, Sarge.
You got it.
Thanks, Carrie.
All right, on this Thanksgiving, lawmakers taking a bit of a break, and guess who is going to stop by right now to join us this morning?
It's Congressman Brian Bilbray.
Brian Bilbray.
Yes, good morning to you.
Good morning.
Happy Thanksgiving.
Yes, they gave us the week to come back and do something. And actually, I got a reprieve. I don't have to go to Tegucigalpa, Honduras, to see the election. I think everybody's going to accept the new election down there, so I get to stay home for the weekend.
Well, good. I know you like it down there, though, because there's usually some pretty good waves around this.
Yeah, and I do very little secret is I'm actually co-chair of the Central American Caucus. You know, we talk a lot about immigration and illegals here, but if we spent more time worrying about their economy than everywhere else, maybe there would be less of an incentive for people to come here illegally. So it's sort of a proactive kind of thing. It's a great part of the world, and I think we ignore it too much.
Yeah, definitely. I think you're right about that. Glad to know you're there. Also, let's talk a little bit about a major decision coming on Tuesday. The president's going to announce exactly how many troops are going to go to Afghanistan. And it looks like the number's higher than some thought, but lower than what others thought.
Well, the concern is that do you do it all with troops? And I think that we've been focusing so much on the troops, and I think the troops need to be sent. But there's some real institutional problems here. I mean, where our civilian money has been going to, these so-called nonprofits, and the money that's been skimming off of there, you know, as the ranking member on procurement, on government oversight, I'm very concerned about. Even the Constitution has not been implemented. You realize they don't have any local government at all, no elected governors, no elected mayors. You talk about you live in some village.
They're tribes.
They're tribes, but 80% of the people live in the backcountry, and they will never be able to elect their mayor or their governor under the existing system. So there's a lot of, we're talking about troops, but there are other things that need to be done. And as our former mayor, I really am outraged that as Americans, we have not done more to institute local governments, state governments, thinking that the American way is to have the federal government control everything. That's a real problem. I think it's a real problem that they're having in Afghanistan that we should learn from and correct.
Let's talk a little bit more about this money that you're talking about. And we've heard sort of rumblings of all these billions of dollars going over to Afghanistan that's never getting to any people who it's intended for. And then the other side of that is apparently we're actually paying members of the Taliban to come over on our side.
Yeah, well, there's a lot of that kind of thing. One of the biggest problems is there's been so much focus about the for-profits in Iraq in the last couple of years. You keep hearing about the Hellebrand and all this other stuff. Mm-hmm. But no one's looking at Iraq for so long because there were nonprofits. Well, nonprofits still make huge amounts of money and can be very corrupt. And that's one of the dirty little secrets that you're going to hear about in the future coming out, that there was so much of this not being directed. And when it's not directed, you're paying off more than just paying a tribal leader to be your friend. You're actually getting a whole lot of corruption institutionalized in a tribal culture that really $500 can be all that somebody earns the entire year. A little bit of money can cause a lot of corruption.
Wow.
You know, let's get back a little bit to how many troops are going to go over to Afghanistan. There was a thought that if there are enough troops to go over, they could operate like they did in Iraq with a surge and provide some sort of support and make a lot of headway with a surge, kind of push back the Taliban, push back Al-Qaeda. Isn't that the goal there, is to get that area under control or get those people under control and then build on to the government?
Yeah, and Bridget, the same people that will attack President Obama for doing this are the same ones who attacked Bush for the surge. And I think we all recognize surge did work.
It worked.
Yeah. But it worked because it wasn't just about soldiers. They also went into Anbar province and taught how to form local governance structure. They actually created that local governance so that the guy in the backwoods felt vested with the government. So the key here is not just sending troops, but what you do to back it up. Use that as an opportunity to build the infrastructure both politically and economically so that you can have a success. So I think the problem is too many people throw soldiers at it, throw the money at it, and it will work out. You got to be smart when you do this. And we were smart in Anbar province. We've really seen a success there. Give the soldiers the chance to get their job done. But I think the biggest rule is this. If we're going to send men and women into harm's way, we have a responsibility to send them all the resources they need to be successful. If you're not going to do that, get them out of harm's way. And I think that's the biggest problem I have is politicians playing politics with people's men and women's lives, and that's a critical component.
Hey, before we let you go, tell us about your event, Toys for Tots, on Saturday.
We've got at 9 o'clock at Miramar, at the Old Club at Miramar, will you bring an unwrapped toy for the Marine, the kids of the Marines. And KUSI, Saquon, and my office are working together, and you bring it over to the USO, bring it over to Miramar, and if it drops off at my office there at Solana Beach off Stevens, we'll find a way to
get it over to the kids.
Yeah.
You know, last year they raised 162,000 toys in San Diego County.
Well, I'll tell you. And, you know, everybody talks about how much we appreciate. And I always just say Thanksgiving for a military family is something that growing up in the Navy, Dad was gone along. You've got a whole lot of people offshore right now. If you really want to say thank you to them, make sure their kids have the toys, because it's the kids and the families that make the ultimate sacrifice, not having the parent around. And as a Navy town, I think that we recognize that the Marines and the Navy really are part of our community, but also a great asset for this community.
Absolutely. For sure. Congressman Bill Bray, thank you so much.
Happy Thanksgiving. I know you have your surfboard on your car.
I'm going surfing with my son right as we leave today. So we'll go with that. And my wife's cooking. Nothing fair about Thanksgiving when it comes to gender, does it?
Yeah. No.
But
no.
She's got some ideas. She got some oyster dressing. I have to cut the oysters up for her. She's from New Orleans, so she does a lot.
Yeah, the oyster stuffing.
Yeah.
I've heard about that.
Good. Mm-hmm.
That and the melatons with shrimp in it. So that's a good thing about marrying a girl from New Orleans.
You are celebrating.
Mm-hmm.
No, I'm getting
hungry.
House, Dan.
Yeah, I know. Thank you, Congressman. Thank you.